Welcome to Rays of Sports. Today, we are taking a look at the top 10 worst Manchester United signings. Stay tuned. Manchester United have one of world football's largest transfer kitties to play about with and have spent plenty of cash to try and achieve their Premier League ambitions. And while it's all well and good having one of the biggest transfer budgets football has to offer, it sometimes doesn't pay dividends. Since the departure of Sir Alex Ferguson from Old Trafford, the greater Manchester outfit have made plenty of mistakes in the transfer world. However, even the great Scott had his share of blunders. Here is a compilation on the top 10 in our list so far. Let's kick things off with Diego Forlán at number 10. A move to an elite European outfit seemed inevitable after Diego Forlán after he struck an impressive tally of 40 goals in 91 games for Independiente. Money-wise, it only cost £7 million for his services back in 2002, but it's fair to say that what could have been a masterstroke instead became a switch to forget. Failing to score in his first 18 appearances set him up for failure, and fail he did in his first two full campaigns in England, hitting the back of the net on just 17 occasions in 77 games. A sorry transfer for all those involved, and the Uruguayan striker left for the basking sun of Spain as he signed for Villarreal. Moving on to number 9, we have Wilfried Zaha. Interestingly, despite being Sir Alex Ferguson's final signing as United boss, Wilfried Zaha never played under the intimidating Scotsman. In fairness, the 31-cap Ivory Coast international struggled to find game time under any of the coaches at the club, David Moyes and Louis van Gaal included. The winger returned to boyhood club Crystal Palace shortly after and he went on to become a legend in the colours of the South London club, having one of the best second spell at club level. Potentially more suited to being a big fish in a smaller pond, Zaha later claimed he was set up to fail at United after he always struggled to find his feet. Next up, at number 8, we have Radamel Falcao. He was one of the most fearsome forwards during his time at Atletico Madrid, but when Manchester United acquired Radamel Falcao on loan from AS Monaco, he was well past his sell-by date. Times were tough at Old Trafford, and with the club looking for some answers post Sir Alex Ferguson, they took a punt on the veteran forward with a £6 million loan deal in 2014. For league goals were all the striker could muster during his time in Manchester, and the excitement following his arrival quickly faded. Obviously, after this poor showing, the Red Devils chose not to pursue a permanent deal for the Colombian, saving themselves £43.5 million in the process and is also considered one of the worst signings of the Glazer era. At number 7 on our list, we have Cleberson. The Atletico Paranaense man was signed alongside Cristiano Ronaldo for £6.5 million back in 2003 after he was part of the World Cup winning Brazil squad. As such, fans expected they were getting an elite maestro in the middle of the park. Nevertheless, Cleberson, despite his hype, failed to meet those expectations. Injuries hounded the Brazilian at Old Trafford like a bad smell, and this was ultimately his real downfall, rather than his lack of talent. With no real run of games under his belt, Cleberson's time at Manchester United ended quite differently from his signing day partner Cristiano. At number 6, we have Alexis Sanchez. Swapped with Henrik Mkhitaryan, Alexis Sanchez arrived at Manchester United from Premier League rivals Arsenal in 2018, with the English top flight at his feet. However, the scintillating form he showed at the Emirates Stadium was never repeated for the Red Devils, and his much-anticipated move was anticlimactic, to say the least. 3 Premier League goals during his 18-month stint at the club were awful returns for the Chilean, and he was allowed to leave on loan to Inter Milan before joining them permanently in 2020. We'll never know what quite went wrong for Sanchez at United, but this is one of the club's worst transfer blunders in recent history. Coming in at number 5 is Juan Sebastian Verón. Joining from Italian outfit Lazio for £28 million in 2001, a hefty fee in those days, the Argentine was expected to play a huge role at Old Trafford. Juan Sebastian Verón was as classy as they come, but his style and elegant finesse didn't quite suit the rough and tough Premier League, and he struggled to make much impact. 7 goals in 57 Premier League games tells you all you need to know, and much more was expected from a player of his caliber and price tag. 2 years later, Verón was signed by Chelsea, ending his disappointing stint at United. This one is more of a what could have been a kind of transfer, with Veron just one of many players to suffer a downturn in form after moving to the Theatre of Dreams. Occupying number 4 on our list, we have Jadon Sancho. Jadon Sancho tipped up to Old Trafford with ample fanfare on the back of his blistering Borussia Dortmund playing days, a stint that saw him score 50 goals and provide 64 assists in a total of 137 outings. His time spent at United has not quite as fruitful, however, which is a shame given how hard the club pushed for his signature for so long. Struggling to emulate his Bundesliga form in arguably the toughest league in the world, he soon found himself becoming an eternal substitute, sharply falling down Ten Hag's pecking order in his winger selection. He flourished again during the 2023-24 season back at Dortmund, helping the German club reach the Champions League final, but it seems unlikely that he'll ever work under Ten Hag again. For number 3, we have Morgan Schneiderlin. If you'd forgotten this man ever put on a Manchester United shirt, we couldn't blame you. Morgan Schneiderlin's Old Trafford career was as dull and uneventful as they come. The Frenchman made 32 appearances in the Premier League for United during his 18-month stint with the club, scoring only once and providing 0 assists. It's not the kind of statistics you want from a player you have forked out £25 million on, and the midfielder will go down as one of the club's strangest purchases over the years. Schneiderlin was sent to Goodison Park, a level where his footballing talents probably belonged, and his swansong story of a big move to Manchester came crashing down. Moving on to number 2, we have Donny van de Beek. Once upon a time, Donny van de Beek was considered one of football's hottest properties. Playing under Erik ten Hag's watch in an imperious Ajax side, the central midfielder was integral to the Eredivisie giants reaching the 2018-19 Champions League semi-finals. He cost the Red Devils £35 million back in 2020. But nobody could foresee how poorly his stint in the English top flight would unravel, with him racking up a mere 62 appearances, 2 goals, and 2 assists in that time. Having joined Eintracht Frankfurt on loan in January, the Dutchman will be hoping he will return to Old Trafford a changed man, one that can mimic his Ajax form. But it's fair to say that the vast majority of United supporters won't be holding their breath. And finally, at the top of our list, number 1, Paul Pogba. For years after leaving Manchester United, Paul Pogba, labelled the club's biggest ever flop, decided to make a triumphant return after some career-best campaigns in Italy with Juventus. Such was his form at the time, United forked out £89 million for his services, hoping the maestro could turn around the club's torrid form since the departure of Sir Alex. 6 years of ups and plenty of downs followed, and Pogba failed to show any of the consistency and class that he demonstrated during his time in the Italian top flight. A free transfer back to Juventus in 2022 is how this one ended, and the injury-plagued Pogba never repaid the Red Devils for that £89 million spent on him. There you have it, guys! The top 10 worst Manchester United signings. One player who still has time to get out of our ranking or worse, move up it, is Antony. The £81.3 million signing for Ajax has so far been a big disappointment for the club, but is still in the first team picture. At the end, it's certainly been a mixed bag for United over the years, and they need to be more prudent in the transfer market going forward if they're going to return to the game's top table. Who do you think should have made or been taken out of the list? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more football content.